Hello there, and I would like to warmly welcome you to my free video tutorial. The subject of this tutorial will be customizing Unreal Kismet using Unreal Script, and I need to explain a little bit more about what I mean by that. And to start to do so, I'm going to show you this level in front of us here. This is the level that we are going to be creating in this tutorial. It will be the result of our work. And perhaps initially this level doesn't look as though it contains anything particularly remarkable. If I move the mouse, you can see it has a floor, it has some walls, it has a ceiling, and at the center of the level it has this portal here, which is suspended in midair. Right now this portal is not animated, it's not doing anything at all, but we can change that. If I press the tab key on the keyboard to bring up the Unreal console at the bottom of the window, and I type the command start anim and then press enter on the keyboard. When I do this, you will notice that all of a sudden the portal begins to spin or roll, and it will continue to do this indefinitely, at least until I tell it to stop. To tell it to stop, I'm going to open the console again by pressing the tab key and typing end anim and then pressing enter. And the portal stops rolling. And I could repeat the start and end anim commands for however many times I wanted to start and stop this portal from animating. Now, there are three main features to notice about this level, three particularly significant features with regards to Unreal Kismet and Unreal Script, and they are going to be the three features we're going to be looking at in this tutorial. So if I start by pressing the escape key on the keyboard to exit out of the play in viewport mode, and I return back to the UDK editor here, if I open up Unreal Kismet by clicking the K icon on the toolbar, you will see that the Kismet graph contains two nodes. The rightmost node is the Matinee node, and this defines the animation for the portal, the animation that we have seen. It defines how the portal will rotate or spin. I'm going to assume for the purposes of this tutorial that you are already familiar with Matinee and how to set up and configure nodes, and that you could, if you wanted, create a similar kind of spinning animation for a similar portal mesh that's featured in this level. But the particularly important node is over here at the left. This event node is called My Custom Event. Now, the first important feature about this custom event node is that it does not come with the UDK. If you download and you install the UDK and then you open up the editor and you try to add a My Custom Event, you will find from all the available event options that there is no such event called My Custom Event. You cannot add one. That is because this My Custom Event node is a new event node that I have created using a class in Unreal Script. This event node contains play and stop connectors, which are connected to the play and stop inputs of the Matinee node here. So that's the first thing to notice, that My Custom Event is a new Kismet event, and it is created on the basis of an Unreal Script class that I have made. The second feature of the level that is particularly significant is to think back, and when I entered the start anim and the end anim commands, these commands actually did something. You may also notice that if you use the UDK based on a fresh install, that if you were to type in start anim or end anim, those commands would not in fact do anything at all. So I have also added the start anim and the end anim commands. I have done that using Unreal Script as well. So we're going to be looking at how to do that. The third and the final feature of the level, is that the start anim and the end anim commands are linked to this my custom event here. In particular, when I entered start anim to begin animating this portal in the viewport here, when I typed start anim, what it actually did was it activated the play socket of my custom event, and the play socket is linked to the play input of the matinee animation, so that when I typed start anim, it caused the play socket of the matinee animation to be activated, and this led to the animation playing. When I typed end anim, it activated the stop output socket of my custom event and caused the matinee animation to stop. So we're going to be looking at how to create custom events in Kismet and how to create functionality that we can launch using console commands, and also how to invoke or activate particular events from Unreal Script. So let's get started. To start with, we're going to need to create two Unreal Script classes.